For this video, we want to talk about what the student sees on their end and then switch back to the teacher view to see what happens when a student turns in an assignment. So, the first thing is, I am now logged in as my demo account. A demo account is an account your district can create for you so you can try the student view within Google Classroom. My demo account is simply called Chromebook 11. Now, for this demo account, my job is to look at the assignment that was assigned to me, which for this one was sample lesson in Google Classroom. I click View Assignment. You'll notice how many points it's worth. There's my instructions. It says go to the doc assignment and let's explore a virtual lesson. Now, for students to do work, it is over here on the right-hand side, just like in question where they reply over here on the right-hand side. When this student clicks, there's a Google Doc that was made shareable to all students. Notice it has my name on it. That tells me that the teacher selected make a copy for all students. My job is to click, and this gets me inside of the document template that the teacher created. This assignment says you're going to pick one of these links or more, find a culture, an area you want to learn more about, and then you're going to write about your experience down below to help create a brochure in the near future. So I take you to Google Arts and Culture for One, which is a Google app that's available for free on the web to teach about different cultures and art around the world. So click Egypt. There'll be different things that you can see in Egypt. So we can look about stories about the Brooklyn Museum, Oasis Rice, the Faras Gallery. So we can look through all of this. Learn a little bit about that. Go back to my doc as a student. I would write what you learned and move to the next. The next one would be Rio. Maybe this is what they wanted to explore. Which Rio Beyond the Map is a great activity to do with students. I would recommend older grades, but it allows them to control their experience. So when you push play, you're now in charge of your environment. Starting with riding on a motorcycle down the streets of the favelas. Notice I'm controlling the screen. And I can continue to the next stop when I'm ready after I've looked. Up here, I can choose what I want to learn about. JR has been introduced by friends. So I can learn about different features using GeoPins. The Brazilian photographer Mark Ferret. Okay, so this is a sample of what they could learn. They go back to Chromebook 11. And then you would write about your experience with this. So, I would say, once again, I learned to add about my brochure. When the student is ready, they will then go back. They could click turn in here if they would like, but I'm actually gonna go back here to show turn in also here, and they could click turn in this assignment. Or if they have more information to share or more work, they could add or create more assignments or more things to turn in for the teacher. If they wanna give a private comment, they could give a comment which gets sent to the teacher as a note. You can do comments before or after the assignment is turned in. So I'm going to turn this in. And now I'm switching back to the teacher view. And I will notice when I refresh that one student has turned in this assignment. There we go. We have one turned in. So if I view the assignment as a teacher, it shows me Chromebook 11 has turned it in. All these have not yet. And I could click inside and view that assignment. Notice it's been updated. This auto updates live, which means you can actually go into all students' assignments and see what they've done. Okay, you can switch back and forth. We're just in Chromebook 11 who's turned it in. You can give a grade over here on the side. You can give a private comment and you can return it when graded. And that's how you do assignments. Now assignments are only limited to the thoughts that you have and different lessons you can engage with students. So what kind of assignments will you do? What kind of adventures will you take them on? It's open to whatever you think you can do with students using different websites, links, and more.